is a zombie movie that's told entirely from the perspective of the zombie, and I'm a fan of zombie films, I'm a fan of the genre, and I wanted to try and find something that I felt hadn't been done in zombie movies the way that I would like to see it. We finished the film, we shot it and edited it, and did the sound all over the course of 18 months. And we took it to Cannes, and it was a global economic crisis. And yeah, and for some reason our story really fitted into what the world seemed interested in as a news story. And we were very lucky, we got a lot of press, and we were able to use that to try and get the film distributed theatrically. Distributors we've had were very willing to give it, because I think they felt it was an interesting enough film to be part of that, I guess, communal experience of viewing a film in the cinema, which I designed it for, because I thought that communal experience would be me and my six mates all gathered in my bedroom. We didn't really have a budget. The idea was just to make it without spending any money, but I think in total we spent somewhere in the region of maybe £40 or £50. We weren't really keeping any kind of track of it. The things that we did spend money on just basically cheap tea, cheap biscuits, a couple of tapes and a crowbar, and that was about it really. Making a film is just kind of one part of the process. It's one of the most important parts, but it's just as important to sell the film once you've got it made. Otherwise you've made a film that's just going to sit in your shelf. Well, I guess the challenges of releasing a film in another country, say for example Japan, which is where we just came from, it's all in the hands of the distributor. They put in as much effort as they like to market the film, and it was something that we were very specific about. We want to find a distributor that will find us the audience for the film, because that's all I'm really interested in. I don't really care about making any money from it. I'm a terrible businessman. But I'm more interested in the film finding an audience, and that to me, it's really exciting when that audience can be, you know, Germany, Austria, Australia, New Zealand, Canada, North America, Japan. The response from Japan has been really positive, and that's the thing that kind of surprised me, because for me the film's, you know, it's a couple of years old now, and the way I tell a story now is very different how I tell a story back then. And every journalist in like 3 days with the press sort of came in and told me they were kind of gushing really about how much they enjoyed the film, and most of their questions were about why did you make this directorial choice, and how did you get that performance out of Alistair, and did you do the same thing with the extras? And it was amazing just to be able to talk about the film. We made a film for the audience to be able to look at and get out of it what they put into it in terms of analysis. And Japanese cinema works in much the same way. There's your surface level story, the piece of entertainment, then there are layers that the audience of their own free will can interpret in their own way. There's no right or wrong way to go about it. You have to find your own way. And this is the way we did it. We were very lucky. Every other filmmaker I know does the exact same thing. They use what equipment they've got available to them to tell their story. There's no excuse these days. The equipment is available for you to be able to tell your story.